I saw an article that said the Trump campaign is demanding that CNN apologize for a poll that shows Biden leading. Do you think you'll get an apology? And kind of what's this back and forth all about?
No, I don't think we'll get an apology. You know, the end justifies the means when it comes to CNN and MSNBC and everybody on the left.
Joining me now is Trump 2020 senior advisor, Katrina Pierson. Katrina, thank you so much for joining me.
Thanks for having me.
And for those of you watching, please don't forget to like and subscribe to The Daily Caller. Now, Katrina, there has been some conversation about the Trump campaign rallies coming back. Number one, is it true? And number two, have you identified any states that you would like to have the campaign rallies in?
It is true, Stephanie. The Trump campaign is ready to get back out on the road. Do not have a schedule for you yet. As you know, some states are just in the process of reopening. Some are still in phase one. Some are transitioning into two. So we're going to put that schedule together. But the president and the campaign are ready to get out there on the road. Each state has different requirements. Like here in my state, you know, they've already ruled that forcing people to wear masks is unconstitutional. God bless Texas. So, you know, we're just going to have to figure out how to navigate each state, and you will see a schedule coming out very soon. The Trump campaign is getting out there. We're opening up offices all over the country. It is time to get this campaign out there with the people.
So I'm assuming, and I don't want to press you on this too hard because you guys are like looking into it and deciding and figuring out the best state to run it in. Some of the states that maybe opened earlier, like Arizona, Texas, like you're in, if you had to pick three states that would be your personal top favorite, not necessarily the campaign's top favorite, where would you choose?
Well, Texas is always going to be my top favorite. There's a lot of, this is Trump country here. So I would definitely pick Texas. But, you know, there's also a lot of other states who have really been reaching out to the campaign, wanting the president to come. It's been a very long time. What was it? Since March, since the president has been out on the trail in a campaign style. So people want the rallies. The president wants to be out with the people. Now is the time. We're on the road to recovery, to this great America comeback, and the president's ready to get back out there with the people.
Yeah, I'm in Arizona right now, and I know there are a lot of folks out here who would love to see President Trump here, but I will warn you, it is hot. It's like sometimes 100 degrees.
I can attest a little bit. You know, it's hot in Texas, but I've been to Arizona a few times and it gets pretty hot there as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And what would a campaign rally look like amid Corona? Coronavirus isn't over and we're starting to see some of the numbers go up. It might be because more people are being tested. It might be because of the reopening. It might be because of the riots and the protests happening and people are shoulder to shoulder, not wearing masks. So coronavirus isn't over. So again, how would the campaign rally, what would it look like?
Well, you know, that's where we are today, sort of looking at, you know, each individual state and the requirements, monitoring the numbers, as you just mentioned, for a whole host of reasons. And that's what's being determined right now. You know, what would the rallies look like? How many people would be allowed? Where would we have them? And that's the phase that we're in at this point.
I have to ask. So we saw some health experts and health officials come out, and these are the critics of people who were the anti-lockdown protesters, the people telling us that we need to continue staying indoors or we're going to put our communities at risk. So some of these health experts and officials are now saying that social justice is more important than social distancing. So you don't hear them criticizing the thousands and thousands of people who are shoulder to shoulder, not wearing masks properly, not wearing masks at all. And, you know, some people even committing crimes, like they don't really have a lot to say about that. So did that play a role in the decision for the campaign to consider doing the campaign rallies again?
No, that didn't really play a role. What played a role is the simple fact that it's time to get out of our houses. It's time to get back to work. It's time to get the country going again. The numbers are going down. There is a lot of testing out there. A vaccine is on the way. So it's really just time, Stephanie. It's really that simple. And, you know, for those who felt like we should keep Americans locked in their homes for 18 months, considering we're seeing people who are out there, as you mentioned, protesting, rioting, no face coverings, no masks, you know, our family and friends couldn't go to a funeral, couldn't go to church. And, you know, some of the people's relatives died alone. Meanwhile, we have the left out there in the streets, you know, with their kegs and their parties, and it's kind of no big deal to them. So, you know, it's just time. It's time to get out there. It's time to get back. It's time to get the campaign going again. And, you know, we're just looking forward to getting out there and telling people the amazing, phenomenal record that President Trump has had over 4 years and contrasting that with Joe Biden's dismal record over four decades, how he's contributed to all of the complaints that we're seeing today in these protests. Joe Biden was person number one to help implement all of the problems that have plagued the Black community. And I want to get out there and tell the entire country just exactly who Joe Biden is.
And we kind of touched on the George Floyd protests. Is this something that the campaign has had conversations about? Because the protests aren't done. And now there's a big conversation in our country about systemic racism, race relations, police brutality, law enforcement in general. Is this something that you all are talking about?
Well, I mean, we talk about everything that's in the news, but I mean, at the end of the day, Stephanie, I mean, you really have to know what's going on in the country to understand that President Trump's been in office for 4 years. These issues that these individuals are complaining about have been going on for decades. So it's really not a Trump issue, because the reality is President Trump has actually undone some of the damage that policies like the 94 crime bill that Joe Biden pushed and said horrible things about African-American youth. Trump has actually undone a lot of that damage. So we feel pretty good that, you know, the president's undoing a lot of that horrific policy that's plagued Black communities for a very long time. A lot of the complaints that are coming out of the protesters are all coming out of Democrat-run areas, whether it be the mayor, the city council, even the governor in many cases. These state and local issues that are causing, or what they're claiming is causing, a lot of the civil unrest in these communities are all Democrat run. So it's not even really a Trump issue. But the president is going above and beyond to try to offer any type of help or resources that he can to all Americans, particularly those who have the least.
Yeah, and you kind of touched on this, but how do you respond to the critics who say that President Trump hasn't been strong on his leadership when it comes to the George Floyd protests and also on racial inequality in the country?
Well, I mean, I say to those people that if they're watching MSNBC or CNN, that might be true for them. However, the president gave a phenomenal speech at the NASA launch and addressed this issue in detail with regard to what happened to George Floyd, his pursuit to for justice in this case. And it was really sad when a lot of the news outlets decided not to cover those televised remarks. So if you're watching mainstream news, you probably don't know what the president has done. And if you saw the Rose Garden speech, you know that he also called on the military and offered those resources to state and local governments. And we haven't seen, you know, a horrible night since then. So the president stepped up and actually put an end to the chaos.
And today I saw an article that said the Trump campaign is demanding that CNN apologize for a poll that shows Biden leading. Do you think you'll get an apology? And kind of what's this back and forth all about?
No, I don't think we'll get an apology. You know, the end justifies the means when it comes to CNN and MSNBC. And everybody on the left. I mean, really what this was designed to do was to really suppress Trump voters, to make people think that those polls were real. But what we find out is that a lot of those people that were polled weren't even registered voters. I mean, it's pretty sad that you have the media who, you know, after all of this, after COVID, you know, after the protests, where they're just saying, oh, Trump's failing. Why then go out of your way to skew polls? I mean, it doesn't make any sense. The reality is our president's doing great. Most people see what's happening. This is not brand new. He's been through hoax after hoax. He's always trailed in the polls and he's always come out on top because he delivers results.
Well, and I'm not even really surprised about the CNN poll because as we know, a lot of these polls oversample Democrats. And so yes. CNN's argument is like, well, our poll's really not that far off from some of the other polls. But that's something I've always had questions about. And, you know, people ask me about the polling. Well, they say, oh, well, Trump's so far behind. Why is that? And I think it's pretty much because they oversample Democrats.
Well, Stephanie, I always point to Rasmussen. Pretty consistent. You know, 2 weeks ago, the president with Black American approval was at 33%. And as of today, it's at 40%. So I think that a lot of the people on the left see how the president is delivering results, how the president is being a president to all Americans. And they're just running scared, and they're doing anything and everything that they can. And we see this happening all around us. They're doing everything they can to try and stop President Trump, but he is the president of the people, and so they will fail.
And what about President Trump's job approval? It appears to have fallen to 39%. Is that something that the campaign's concerned about?
Well, no, because it's a snapshot in time. And when you look at all of the things a president has had to deal with and overcome successfully, might I add, all those numbers are going to change. But at the end of the day, even if we look at 2016, the president trailed in the polls the entire time because they were oversampling Democrats and they were skewing some of the polls. So, you know, the polls that I take are the polls that I get when I go to another state. When I'm out there, you know, checking my messages, I see the number of people. It doesn't matter what color, what gender, what orientation. People see that this president is doing everything that he can for them, and they can also see that the Democrats and the left are doing everything they can against them.
Katrina, as you know, the election's just right around the corner, and also we might be facing the second wave of coronavirus. What is the campaign preparing to do to handle that? I know that you guys already have your digital infrastructure, but is this something that you're prepared for?
Yeah, you know, and it's not even just about coronavirus, because we're coming up on a whole nother flu season. So it's going to be something that I think everyone is trying to figure out right now, because with flu season coming in, there's a lot of people who aren't going to know if they have antibodies unless they get a test. There's a lot of people who aren't sure what they're going to have, if it is the flu at all. So I think we're just going to have to take it step by step. Perhaps there'll be a vaccine by then. I'm not quite sure yet, but I think it's worth continuing to have the discussion on a day-by-day basis and take the information as it comes in accordingly. But at this point in time, we're not going to live in fear. We're not going to live in fear. The American people deserve a campaign that's going to go out there and ask them for their vote. And we at the Trump campaign are going to do just that.
Well, Katrina, we're going to leave it here. Thank you so much for spending time with us. We really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.